I shared last week, we're going to continue talking about hearing God. So listen up. There's a play on words there, listen up. Like I shared last week, I don't know about you, but I've never heard the audible voice of God. But I can say without a shadow of a doubt that God speaks to me all the time. Every day I sense God speaking to me in whatever way he chooses, directing me, challenging me, encouraging me, not in a big loud shout, not in obvious ways, but in a still small voice, which is why we have to tune in and listen up. I posed a question last week about how we potentially miss what God's saying because we're listening for the wrong voice. We're listening for Brian Blessed to bellow down from heaven when actually God is just doing it in a very gentle way. And I think the number one reason why many don't hear God very often is because they talk too much and listen too little. Prod your neighbor and say, he might just be talking about you. A few didn't do it then. Clearly I need to talk about, you know, without sounding like this is really heavy, I need to do a message on authority here because no one's listening to a thing I'm saying. Go on, just prod your neighbor. I really actually encourage you just to prod your neighbor and say, actually, he's talking about me. Now that's easier, isn't it? That's easier. I also shared last week that when it comes to hearing God, he speaks to our spirit. We get an impression. We sense a prompting. We feel a nudge. Jesus said in John 10:27, my sheep listen to my voice. I know them and they follow me. So in order to hear him, we have to learn to discern his voice, which is why our quiet times are so important, because he speaks into our spirit through his word. And it's in those times, it's making sure we prioritize those times because they equip us so that we'll know his voice at any point in any given situation. It's no good trying to get to know God's voice when we're in a situation of need. We need to know his voice by that point. We need to know what we're listening for so that we will know when he's speaking to us. So last week, we covered three ways that God speaks. I said that he's our life coach. I said that he's our speech therapist. And I said that he's our financial advisor. And you may remember, we had some fun, didn't we, last week? And one of the things we had fun over was when we were talking about finances and hearing God in our finances and hearing those two words that he so often speaks, which is wait and don't. We always hear do, but we very rarely hear wait and don't. And I think there's something to be said about waiting. And I was telling you a story of how we had ended up in a situation where we had some doors, some internal doors for our house when we were first renovating it. And we had to take them back because they're all different shades. And we were thinking, oh, what are we going to do now? We couldn't find any doors. And we were basically really felt like we were nudged in a way and prodded towards wits. And I told you the story of how we went down that aisle really not expecting to find anything because we really thought that wits was going to be so expensive, only to find that there were some doors with this label on, which I didn't bring last week. And if you can't see that, it says reduced to clear. And you, if you want to have a look at this after, I'll leave it out in the front here. Please don't nick it because I'm keeping this for messages. But it says deleted and it says was $99.99, and I got it wrong last week. I'd forgotten that actually they weren't reduced to $9.99. They were reduced to $9.97. Every penny counts. So we got 10 doors for the normal price of one. And these stickers were on every door. I kept looking behind every door thinking they've got the sticker wrong on the front one. Surely it can't be £9.97. Do they mean 99.70? No. When I got to the till, not only were they £9.97, but then we had a 10% discount code or card that we gave over, and we got a further discount, and they said that we wouldn't be able to get any more doors. And then when we found ourselves back in Wickes one day, not really knowing why we were there, we were just wandering around, and we walked down that aisle again, and we saw another, I forget how many it was, five doors, and they were reduced to the same price, having said that they would never have those doors back in. And now we've discovered that we've actually got enough doors for our entire house. So that's amazing. That's an amazing story of, you know, waiting on God, because he does have these things lined up. We can think that, you know, I think there's even a tendency to think that it's actually wrong to actually rely on God for our finances. But why do you think Jesus talks so much about money? In fact, let me just put that straight and say, we can't rely on anybody else for our finances. We have to rely on God. You know, you are in a job not just because of how well you do that job. That does play a part. But even the best people in the best jobs end up in situations where they are made redundant, where they are sacked for unjustifiable reasons, and they find themselves having to trust in God because there is no other way to trust for finance. And that's why Jesus talked so much about it, so that he could be our financial advisor. And so when he says wait, there's a good reason why he's saying it. When he says don't, there's a good reason why he doesn't want us to go ahead. Makes me want to climb up.